Welcome back to Pelangi 21. Today I will show you Heartstopper Episode 8. Boyfriend opens with Charlie trying to reach out to Tao. When he doesn't respond, he plays music to help him take his mind off. But his sister Tori doesn't want to deal with the noise and tries to get Charlie to open up about what is going on. Charlie blames himself for Nick and Tao's fight with Harry. He opens up about how much Ben messed with his head and now Nick is suffering because of him. If he weren't around, then everyone would be okay. Tori knows this isn't true and continues to comfort him. The next day, Charlie shows up at school, and while Isaac is willing to talk to him, Tao is giving him the silent treatment. The sports day between Truam and Higgs is coming up, and because he is on the rugby team, he will be expected to participate with them and not his friends. After class, Charlie runs into Nick in the hallway and blows off his request to get lunch together. Instead, he heads to Coach Singh and quits the rugby team. She's trying to ask if any team member is bothering him, but Charlie just claims that rugby isn't for him. Meanwhile, Nick confronts Tao during lunch to figure out what is going on with Charlie. Tao is over trying to protect Charlie from everything when he doesn't even act like he exists. Nick tells him that Charlie must have been really nervous about telling him about them. Because Charlie cares about Tao's opinion and doesn't want to disappoint him. The conversation flips to why Charlie's ignoring Nick. Nick thinks it is because he doesn't want to have to keep lying about their relationship. Tao gives him some insight into how Charlie thinks, and that he constantly blames himself for other people's problems. He also might be too afraid to tell Nick that he wants to be something more than a secret relationship. Tao still understands that Nick isn't ready to come out yet, and suggests Nick to talk to Charlie. Later that night, Nick tries reaching out to Charlie again, but he doesn't answer him. The next day, Elle, Darcy and Tara arriving at Truam. It's the first time Elle is around everyone she left behind, and while she is nervous, she wants to be there. As the school gets ready for the event, Charlie keeps on avoiding Nick. Tao finds Elle and tells her that he hasn't even signed up for anything. Isaac eventually shows up, and when Elle asks about Charlie, no one has seen him. Inside, Charlie meets up with Mr. Ajayi to hide away. He realizes that something must be going on with Charlie, and even if he doesn't want to open up about it, he gives him some advice. It might seem easier to hide from one's problems, but the loneliness can be just as bad, if not worse. He tells him that he won't kick him out of the art room, but he needs to not let people make him disappear. Outside, Coach Singh catches Tao and assigns him the 200-meter run even though he sucks at running. Thankfully, Charlie comes to his rescue and willing to replace him. He apologizes to Tao for all of the trouble he caused before heading over to the race. Ben participates in the race and makes cynical comments. Charlie is focused on the race and manages to beat him. At the end of the race, Charlie finally defends himself from Ben. Afterward, Charlie and Tao finally apologize and move past their fight. They both understand that they could have been better friends but are willing to work together to get past this. Tao leaves Charlie to wander the halls with Elle, while the rest of the school watches Tara in the high jump and Isaac in the javelin throw. Inside, Elle and Tao sneak into the art room. He shares his terrible landscape with her, and she debates telling him about her feelings, but Elle chickens out at the last minute and instead tries to rub his face paint off. They almost kiss, before Elle dips off to find her old locker. The rugby match kicks off, and Charlie leaves his little hideaway with Isaac to watch the action and cheer Nick on. But Nick isn't up for playing rugby and leaves the field, then grabs Charlie's hand and drags him off in front of everyone. Inside, Nick confronts Charlie about all of this breakup stuff, and tells him that he doesn't care about getting into fights with his mates or making people angry because Charlie is worth it. Being with Charlie is the best thing that has happened to him, and he isn't willing to throw it away. The two of them share a kiss, then Nick asks Charlie if he is free this upcoming Saturday. The following weekend they go on a date. Nick won't tell Charlie where they are going. They leave by train, then Nick finally reveals that he has taken Charlie to the beach. They spend the day riding rides, taking photos, getting food, even kissing. While laying on the beach, Nick opens up to Charlie about deciding that he wants to come out. This excites Charlie, but he wants to make sure that this is something that Nick is sure of. He feels like he knows who he is, and doesn't want to sneak around anymore. He wants them to be able to be honest with their friends and family and be honest with themselves, so now they are officially boyfriends. Nick holds Charlie and tells the world how he feels, and nearly dropping Charlie into the ocean. Later on, Nick returning home to find his mom in the kitchen. With his newfound confidence, Nick sits down and tells his mom that Charlie is his boyfriend. His mom hugs him and supports him to be himself. The final scene shows a montage of Nick falling in love with Charlie over the past few months. Then they're at the beach. Charlie asks if he can tell everyone now, and Nick says yes. The series ends with Nick and Charlie cuddling on the beach. It was a great way to end the first season of Heartstopper. Nick and Charlie worked through their issues and came out as a couple. Elle and Tao still need a lot more development in their relationship. Tara and Darcy managed to improve their relationship. I hope they show more of the other characters like Isaac, who is asexual. Overall, this first season was great and fun, and one of the best series. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notification.